is officially our last day on the Pennine Way. Read so much about it and I've seen so many YouTube videos on it, so I'm really happy that we're gonna go up there as well. I've made it. Oh my gosh. This was so hard. I'm really in love with the Peak District. Probably not my favorite trail so far. Unfortunately, couldn't enjoy it on quite a few days. I don't want to like bash it too much.
Hi, my name is Ellie. I'm a long distance hiker and backpacker. With my rescue dog Otto, I'm currently hiking the length of Britain from Scotland to Cornwall. Come join us for our final days on the Pennine Way, where we hiked from Wessenden Reservoir to Croden, then on to Edale to finish the Pennine Way, before making our way west to Hayfield.
Good morning! We had a great night's sleep. It wasn't cold at all. It was really mild and comfortable. Really like falling asleep to the sound of the water. We have a very short day today. I think it's only 8 or 8.5 miles. We are going to hike to Croden today. There's a campsite. Apparently there is a washing machine. And I'm so happy after 2.5 weeks of sweating and hiking, I can use the washing machine there, which is great. So let's go. That's Black Hill. Ooh, this looks so lush. I don't know if you can see it on the camera, but it's so green and perfect. Oh, wow. To the campsite, and it's a really great spot. They're so welcoming. I already washed my clothes, I took a shower, and yeah, just it's still early, it's only 3:30, and yeah, I'm enjoying a rest, and it's perfect. And to make this day even better, there's no shop on the site, but there is a takeaway that delivers to the site, and they gave me the flyer, so I'm just waiting for 5 p.m. when the takeaway opens. I'm gonna order a lot, I think, because I'm really hungry. I'm gonna rest a little bit before our final push to E-Day tomorrow, and yeah, this day couldn't be any better. Good morning! This is officially our last day on the Pennine Way. We're gonna hike to E-Day today. There's a really big climb coming up. I think the second longest on the whole trip, and it's supposed to be really warm today. I think I'm gonna reflect on my final thoughts on the Pennine Way today a little bit, because it's really, yeah, it was a trail of mixed emotions. But for now, one last stretch on the Pennine Way, so let's go. So interesting. I can clearly see Manchester over there, but yet here in the Peak District it's so remote and you feel like being far away from everything, when in reality it's really not that far away from civilization. And it's so interesting to have this big space of like vast moorland area and hills and everything, just yeah, in the middle of a very urbanized area. It's yeah, it's really interesting. Another milestone on the Pennine Way, that's a Kinder Plateau, a very famous and well-known area for hiking in the UK hiking community, and I've read so much about it and I've seen so many YouTube videos on it, so I'm really happy that we're gonna go up there as well. We're gonna hike up. I think the Pennine Way goes over Kinder Low and passes Kinder Downfall as well. I'm so happy I get to see that. On the Pennine Way, and the last of many, many, many trek points and peaks that we've climbed in the last 3 weeks, we made it to Kinder Low. Oh, I'm so happy, and I think now it's all downhill from here to E-Day for the last couple of miles, and oh, I'm so happy. This is gorgeous. Oh, I really like this ending to the Pennine Way. We are only about 2.5 miles away from E-Day, and oh, this has been incredible today. It's been so hard, but the views were amazing. Wow, this is so incredible. I can't believe it, but I'm here. I've made it. Oh my gosh. This was so hard, and but I did it, and oh, this is incredible. We did it! We made it to the campsite in Edale, and it was a bit of a shock because it's so crowded. There are so many people here. I mean, it's normal, it's Saturday and it's great weather, but still it was like I came around the corner and there were like so many people. I had some food, I had 2 pints, and yeah, just press it for a bit. I can really feel my feet, they're a bit sore from all the climbing and mainly from going downhill, but yeah, I'm really happy that we've made it. Tomorrow we're gonna have a shorter day. So, see you then. Good night. Good morning. We just left the campsite in Edale. We slept in a little bit. We have a shorter day today, only about 9 miles. And we're gonna go over another iconic peak. We're gonna hike over Mam Tor and then to another campsite. The forecast is not so great for the afternoon. There's probably some thunderstorms coming and some heavy rain. So it's nice to have a shorter day and rest for a little bit after we hiked the Pennine Way. And for us, it's such a short time. So yeah. I think it's gonna be a great day, although it's already very hot. So let's go! This is our second climb for today. Oh, it looks really steep. We are almost in Hayfield now. Our endpoint for today. It's been very tough. I thought it wouldn't be that much elevation, but it was pretty tough, especially in the heat. And even though it's a shorter stretch, I'm very tired, and I think Otto's tired too, and we're very happy to get there soon and yeah, just to set up the tent and have a little rest. I'm really in love with the Peak District. It's so beautiful, and I definitely want to come back here and do more hiking. It really is incredible. And I thought maybe to share my final thoughts on the Pennine Way, because I know I have complained quite a bit if I'm being totally honest, the Pennine Way has been a lot harder than I thought it would be. Maybe I should have researched it more. I researched like the resupply options and everything, and I also saw the elevation in total for the whole trail. But yeah, it's just numbers. If you see it and you think, okay, it's not that bad, but yeah, if you're out, that's a totally different story then. And I don't know why, but I somehow underestimated the Pennine Way, and it was a lot harder than I thought it would be. First off, it's very remote in a lot of places. I mean, you're not far away from civilization, but the Pennine Way is created as a footpath, so it's designed not to go through like bigger cities all the time. Obviously you want to enjoy the countryside, which is perfect, and you see a lot, but you don't pass along shops very often. Like in the bigger villages, yes, but even then there are like smaller general stores that are, for example, closed on Sunday, or pubs that are closed on Monday to Wednesday. On some days I really missed that. There's like nothing to buy food, nothing to get food. And yeah, I really like my coffee. I really like to stop somewhere, and then yeah, there's nothing to have a break, really. Yeah, that's one thing that was hard for me. Yeah, you have to carry, especially if you don't do really big days, you have to carry quite a bit of food, and with auto stock food even more. So yeah, that was tough. Also the terrain itself, it's for some parts it's very uneven terrain and rocky, and if it's wet, obviously some parts will be very boggy and very hard to hike across. It's one of the reasons why I think the Pennine Way is a very tough trail, is because it's very exposed in any weather. If there's thunderstorms, you don't want to be on top of a ridge for the whole day, basically 600 meters above sea level. If it's sunny, there's literally no shade in form of trees, which is also something very different from the highlands, for example, where there's more wooded areas. If it rains, obviously, yeah, you're very exposed in any weather. Then obviously we went in the opposite direction of basically everyone else, which yeah, made it a bit lonely here and there, because obviously you're meeting people, but you only see them once and then they're off. Would have been easier if we have met other people and maybe met them again and throughout our trail. That would have helped, I think. Then there's a lot of farmland on some stretches. On a few, there's, you go through farmland almost all day, which I found very annoying, because there are a lot of like cattle field and going over stiles and stopping, and you can't get into a real like rhythm if you have to open a gate or go over a stile like every 300 meters on some stretches. I think these are my final thoughts, or why it's probably not my favorite trail so far, just because it was so incredibly hard, and I unfortunately couldn't enjoy it on quite a few days. But that being said, I would love to return and do it again, maybe in another season, or maybe if it's just the Pennine Way, maybe post myself more resupply packages along the trail to have a lighter pack and not carry that much food, or yeah, because the landscape really is incredible. I especially the Yorkshire Dales, I like them a lot, and the days with more open spaces, like open moorland areas, and the Peak District, I really liked it a lot, so I don't want to like bash it too much. The scenery, the landscape is incredible. I really like that, but yeah, as I said, it was quite tough and I struggled for quite a bit, but I mean, we've made it. Happy that we finally made it to Edale, and yeah, I think I will come back to the Pennine Way and to give it another chance maybe. But yeah, it was it was very nice to have done it and to have seen this iconic trail, but it's not all sunshine and happiness. And now I'm very excited for the next part of our hike, but for now just gonna get to the campsite and have a little rest, and see you tomorrow.